So picture the scene. It's the mid-2000s, downtown LA. It's a giant, sleek, glossy, like not too high-end, but quite high-end hotel. And it's full of advertising executives who've flown in from all over the world to talk strategy for 2 or 3 days. For the purposes of description, everyone is wearing black and wearing sunglasses indoors. And I have no recollection of what happens on the stage until one day, the doors fly open and Benjamin Zander, who is conductor of the Boston Philharmonic Orchestra, strides onto stage with this enormous personality and a grand piano and instructs us all to sing Ode to Joy in German and Happy Birthday with gusto and plays Chopin to make everyone cry. Now you can imagine the response of this jet-lagged, cynical international audience who largely sit back and fold their arms. But somewhere behind the BlackBerry looking and the shifting nervously in the seats and his enthusiasm, there's a connection and he builds it. And he said something that day that I remember now and think about probably most days. He told the story of bringing a group of students to London when he was working in the States and giving them a year of cultural education of theatres and shows and concerts and museums. And one day he got some really, really prized tickets for a concert. And it was incredible, life-changing. It was amazing to be able to go. And most of them didn't turn up. So he was beyond furious, embarrassed to the hosts and furious with the students. And he went home to tell his therapist wife, who said, well, what didn't you do? Did you not tell them how exciting it would be? Did you not tell them how prized these tickets were? Did you not tell them that this is what they were here to do and that this was an amazing opportunity? And his advice on the back of this was that every time we tell stories that we're the hero of.
My name is Maximus Decimus Maximus, husband to Maximus.
Where we say, I delivered this project, but so-and-so was late, and so-and-so was not world-class, and so-and-so was lazy and didn't do it in the right format, that we turn that on ourselves and we absorb the responsibility. And we ask ourselves, well, why didn't they know why the deadline was important? And why didn't they do it in the right format? And why weren't they committed to delivering their best possible work? What did I not do to take them with me? When I've given people this advice over the years, they've often got really cross with me and said, well, why am I going to take more responsibility for everyone else's shit?
I don't want to take on what they're crap at. How does that help me?
The magic of Zander's advice is that for a moment you do feel that gurning, awful responsibility, but that because we don't like that feeling, we immediately turn it into action. Okay, so what could I do to make them understand why this is important, to show them why the deadline matters, to help them have the tools that they need to deliver the best possible performance? What didn't I give them? And if I hired the wrong person, then that's on me. I need to take that and I need to deal with it. And it actually empowers you and energizes you to be able to fix the stuff that otherwise is just you being a hero and everyone else being a moron. I can be your hero, baby. The question then for you this week is, when have you taken in that responsibility, breathed it in, and thought, how could I change the outcome and get everyone to do the absolute best they can? What could I have said? What could I have done that would have made a difference? Really, really interested in your stories and where it maybe made a difference or maybe didn't. Anything else I learned in LA? It's lost in a fog of bar crawls and stretch limousines and very dodgy nightclubs. I've got nothing else for you on the subject. Have a really, really good Friday and I'll see you next week. I can be your hero.